Okay guys, as I promised, here you have a recipe for a Spanish paella. I hope that you enjoy, stay at home, take care of yourself and enjoy the food. For today's dish, we're gonna need tomato, garlic and onion, the base of any Spanish food. Then we're gonna use this kind of rice that you can find in Mariano's, Chulolosco, you can find it also in Whole Food and even in Smith. Then if you have a little bit of pimenton, a Spanish recipe, delicious, from my hometown. If not, you can also use paprika. Then we are gonna use scallops, shrimps, crab legs, and mussels. If you don't like seafood, you can also use like meat, like chicken cubes or little pork ribs. Normally we use like a wider pan, you know, to make it like delicious and thin. But as long as I don't have a paellera, I'm gonna use what I have at home, a big pot. And as long as I have two kids, instead of using just one box of rice, I'm gonna use two, because they are like animals. First, we're gonna put everything together, like shrimps, mussels, and crab legs. And we are going to cover it with water and boil it. That is going to be the sauce for the rice. Remember, don't put the scallops, because those will be added at the end. So you cover it with water, put it on the fire, and wait until they start boiling. While we wait till the seafood boil, we cut the tomatoes, the garlic, and the onions. Another important ingredient in this is that extra virgin olive oil. Don't believe everything that you read at the supermarket. Even if they say that it's Italian, 70% of the Italian olive oil is Spanish. Well, even before they start boiling, if you can see here, you know, as soon as the mussels start opening and the shrimp start getting this orange color, I think it's time to turn it off, okay? Because the rest is gonna be done in the pan with the rice. So now you place a new recipe to hold the liquid. Put something to filter the water. So now we have our sauce for the rice. Okay, we have our seafood to add it later. And what is more important when you are cooking, as long as you cook, you steam everything, so you will maintain your kitchen clean. It's very important. And okay, that is when the mother of all the battles will start. We're gonna put in the pan a little bit of olive oil. That's enough. Okay. Don't remember to do it on a low fire, and put a little salt so the onion can brighten by itself, okay? All right, don't add the tomato yet, wait a little bit. Now, when the garlic starts getting direct, a little brown, you know, add the tomato and mix it up. Very important, keep the fire medium low, okay? And sorry about my broken English, but normally when somebody make fun of a person who has a broken English, that normally means that he either talk one or two other languages, so having to consideration. When it looks like this, more or less, is the time to use a little bit of killing tongue, or if you don't have it, a little bit of paprika. Okay? Don't keep it so long on the fire, because if not, it will be like a little bit like nasty and bitter. So move it around. You're gonna have a wonderful smell, you know, of a killing tongue or paprika. So now it's time to add the rice. As I say, one box is enough for 4 servings. But as long as I have 2 little kids that they ate like animals, I'm gonna add another extra pack. And now you move it around. You saute it for los reolas, ¿vale? In less than a minute, when you have it something like this, then you're gonna start adding the sauce that we have done before, okay? With the mussels, the shrimps, and the crab legs. And then you move it around. Now it's time to turn the fire a little bit up until it starts boiling. It has to look something like this, okay? And then we're gonna leave it for 20 minutes, half an hour, depending on how you like the rice. Okay, and then I'm gonna explain you another trick. I will see you in 20 minutes. If you couldn't find the rice that I said at the beginning of this video, now is the time that you can add saffron, cumin, curcuma, whatever spices you want or you like. Once that the rice starts boiling, put it on the low fire so it will cook slowly and nicely. Meanwhile, we will have a little extra sauce just in case we need more liquid, and the seafood getting ready to go inside. Yeah, yummy. And don't forget to taste the sauce and the rice, you know, depending on what you like, because sometimes people like it like harder, the rice, you know, smooth. You can add more salt, some spices. Anyway, now is the time to do it. And this is my son helping me out to peel some shrimps to add at the end of the bite. Okay, we're almost done. The rice is getting like soft, really nice. So now is the moment to add all the seafood that, as you can see, we have it here. We have peeled the shrimps, the mussels. We are going to leave some of the mussel and shrimp without peeling, just for the appearance, for the presentation. Okay, so, and here we have things that we thought that we didn't forget about you. You're gonna be added now, okay? Well, it has to look something like this, right? So, bon appetit, buen provecho. Leave it for 5 minutes to rest before you eat it. And if there is something left, oh my God, that is a really nice tapa for tomorrow with a glass of wine. Enjoy. And that is it. So next week we are gonna make like some lentils with chorizo.